to my channel. If this is your first time of coming to my channel, thanks a lot. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. So in today's video, we are going to make a simple video on how to cut 3 layers flare gown. 3 layers flare gown. So what are the basic measurements required? Our waist measurements, bust measurements, hip measurements, and our gown length. So I'm going to go ahead and calculate our measurements. So our bust is 36 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 10.5. Our waist is 30 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 2, we have 10. Our hip is 38. 38 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 11. Our gown length is 37 plus 2 inches for our sewing allowance, we have 39 inches. Now, basically, these are the basic measurements required. But when you want to achieve your 3 layers flare gown, you are going to make use of the largest measurement. And with my measurements, the largest measurement we have is our hip measurement, which is 36. For some individual, the large part of their body might be their bust measurement, some might be their waist, and for most people, it is usually the hip measurement. So note that you have to make use of the largest measurement when you want to cut your 3 layers flare gown. So because the largest measurement we have is 38, which happens to be my hip measurement, after calculating all our basic measurements, we have 11 inches. But our 3 layers flare gown, it is not a fitted gown. What you want to achieve at the end of the day is like a free gown, which you are going to understand when we cut the fabric and in the process of this video. So I'm going to go ahead and add about 5 to 6 inches to the largest measurement that I have, because that is what I'm going to be making use of. So I have 11 inches and go ahead and add 6 inches extra just to have this ease around my measurement. So I'm going to have 17 inches. So I'll be using this hip measurement to cut out the amount of fabric required for us to achieve our 3 layers flare gown. So don't forget to join us on Facebook, T-Designs, and also visit our website. I'm going to put down the details in the description box. On our website and on our Facebook page, we have different fashion topics with detailed illustration on how to achieve that. So make sure you visit our Facebook and also visit our website. And you can also join us for training, both online training and physical training. All the details are going to be in the description box below. So for today's topic, which is 3 layers flare gown, we are going to be achieving it using freehand method. What do I mean by freehand method? It simply means that we are going to be achieving it directly on fabric without making use of our pattern paper. So in this case, we don't need our pattern paper, but we are going to be cutting it directly on the fabric. So now let's move straight into the fabric. Is that we are going to make use of this plain fabric to get our inner first. So, because we are making use of our hip measurement, which happens to be the largest part of our body measurement, we went ahead and folded our fabric into 4. So, this is what I have into 4. Now, it is usually off shoulder. So, you determine how many inches you want to take off your basic measurement. So, let's say I'm taking about 5.5 inches off. Note that it varies on what you want to achieve and how off you want it to be. So, from this 5.5 inches, you can see that we have 5.5 inches off the tape, off the measurement, right? So, from this 5.5 inches, you now take your gown length, which happens to be 39 inches. So once you have done with that, the next thing you are going to do now is to make use of our measurement, which we have as 17 inches, which we have as 17 inches to have our measurements, because it is a very free gown inside. So we have 17 inches, which that was what I used to fold the fabric into 4. So I'll go ahead and connect it together and we'll cut this out. To know how many inches required for our leg, this is our fabric. Now, our shoulder to waist is 17 inches, right? Our shoulder to waist is 17 inches. And we took away 5.5 inches for the off shoulder. So we took away 5.5 inches for the up shoulder, and our shoulder to waist is 17. So this is where we have 17 inches. So this is where we are going to place our first layer of flame, where we have this 17 inches. Now, you will now measure what you have for the rest. We have 20 inches left, so we'll mark 10 inches. Now, because the lower part of it, you are going to aim it, so we are going to use 9 inches or 8.5 inches for the second flame. Because 1 inch of this part is going to be end inside. So when you are dividing this lower part into two, you should also take note of that. So this is where we'll place our second flame. So it means that the first flame will be here. That is, we'll place the first flame here. The second flame here. This is where we have our waist. And then we'll place the third flame here. So this helps you to know where to place your flame. The number of inches required for you to achieve your flame. Now, fold your plain fabric into two. That is your front block and your back block. And let's check what we have. So we have 25 inches. It simply means for the front block we have 25 inches. And for the back block we have 25 inches. Because it is a free gown. So don't forget that our sewing allowance too is added to it. So we'll set this aside into two, and to fold our fabric in a triangular form. Now we have 25 inches, and we are cutting six pieces of the flay. So at this point, I'll check where I have about 7 inches. So this is where we have 7 inches. So we'll place it this way. We have 9. Place it this way. So you connect the curve together. So this is the curve. So you go ahead and check your curve to be sure of what you have. So we have about 8, and it's folded into 4. Now from this point, now we are going to mark our length, the main piece. This is where we started from. So we are going to measure what we have for the length to know the number of lengths we'll be using for the flay. So we have 12 inches. So we set that aside. That's for the first layer of our flay. And then we'll go ahead and mark 12 inches. So this is where we have 12 inches. So you place your tape measure this way. That is 22. Place it this way. So you go ahead and connect it together. So this is the curve of our flay. So I'll go ahead and cut this out. I'm going to use these pieces and cut another one. So after cutting it out, we have 2 pieces, right? So I'm going to make use of this plain piece to cut it out, because the marking is not showing on this layer of the flay. We've gotten the first layer. So for the second layer of the flay, we'll go ahead and check what we have. Now, because the second layer will move in a little so that it overlaps each other, I'm going to take 1 inch above the line. And so we'll measure what we have. So we have 10 inches for the second layer length. So I'll go ahead and fold my fabric, and I'll place this. Now, because this is 12 inches and the one we want to achieve is 10 inches, it simply means I'm going to reduce the length, but this part will remain the same. So I'll go ahead and cut it out. So we've cut out the 2 pieces. That's for the second layer of our flay. So for the third layer, we are going to place our tape measure with 1 inch, because it's going to fall under the second layer, and then we'll check what we have. Don't forget that we are going to fold 1 inch at the lower part, because we are going to end the lower part. So you fold 1 inch. So we have 12 inches for the third layer. 12 inches for the third layer. So we'll go ahead, this is where our third flay should start from. So I'll go ahead and control my flame this way. I'll stitch it all the way on this second line. That is where we are going to have our second flame. So this is what we'll have. You can see that the stem is coming up already, and you can see that this second flame overlaps on this third flame. So we'll go ahead and stitch it all the way. So we'll go ahead and fix the first one up, and you can see that this one overlays on each other. So go ahead and stitch it. Three layer, the first, second, and the third. So for the upper part now, we are going to go ahead and fold it. Now, when you are folding it, it's better you just interlock the tip. So while you are folding it, we are going to fix in our elastic, and I'm making use of this 1-inch elastic. So I'll go ahead and fix the elastic here. While I'm sewing it, I'll be pulling the elastic. So let's go. After passing the elastic, so you can see what we have. So we are going to go ahead and decide. So that after stitching the side, I'll show you guys what it looks like.